Hey guys, what's up? It's Girl Danielle. In today's video, I'm gonna share with you 3 tips that you can use to help with diaper changes to make them a little more comfortable.
Call me a saint, but you know I'm a stranger, a willing and
Alright guys, look, if you're new here, my channel is all about diapers. So whether you are a parent, a caregiver, or you wear a disposable diaper or a brief, this channel is definitely going to be the place for you. So go ahead and lock it in, subscribe, and smash the like button. Alright, so the very first thing you want to do is be prepared and have all of your incontinence products readily available. Expect either a wet diaper or a diaper that's going to have a bowel movement inside. You want to come prepared. So you want to make sure you have your wipes. If not, and you choose to have some type of gentle cleanser and warm water, have that nearby. Have a dry bath towel. You need to have some type of diaper cream near to you. And let's not forget, have at least 2 to 3 disposable bags so that you can contain the bowel movement inside. Part of being a compassionate caregiver is to find ways to preserve the integrity of the person of whom you're caring for. They may not be aware that they just had a bowel movement. So it's your job to make sure that you don't have to announce that. You don't have to say, okay, I'm changing a poopy diaper here, poopy diaper everybody. You don't have to do that. That's taken away their dignity. So what you can do is just be totally prepared. Have at least 2 to 3 disposable bags near. So when you're through with that diaper change, you're able to discreetly wrap it all up, tie it up, and just move it away. Finally, you want to make sure that you have a diaper already on hand, maybe a diaper or 2 on hand, and readily available for the change. Tip number 2, if you're caring for somebody with limited mobility or bedridden, remember to be patient and respectful. Incontinence is not a choice for that person you're caring for. Incontinence is when you cannot control your bladder or your bowel movement. So be sensitive and don't take away their dignity. Tip number 3, be a good communicator and work quickly. Communication is important and can be soothing. For example, as a woman, whenever I'm going to my gynecologist and I'm getting ready for that dreaded pap smear, even though I know already what's going to happen, I'm quite sure about what she's going to do, it's still nice for her to walk me through the steps. It's still nice to tell me what she's doing and what's gonna come next, if I'm gonna feel a little pressure or what to expect. So it's really nice for her to walk through the steps and communicate with me. So as a caregiver, if you are caring for a child, a patient, a parent, or a relative, it's very important for you to let them know what's going on and the steps to expect. Walk them through it. Just that little bit of communication is going to ease the stress, it's going to take away the embarrassment, and it's going to give them back their dignity. Remember, when you're caring for somebody with incontinence, the goal is to approach the problem with sensitivity and help manage the condition while preserving dignity, comfort, and hygiene. All right, look, thanks so much for tuning in for today's video. And if you are new here, go ahead and subscribe and smash the like button, and I will totally see you on my next video. Mwah. Until next time.